everyone. In the last few weeks, I got a bunch of emails from people asking me to talk more about the story I shared on Facebook, where this woman got poisoned by her skin lightening cream. Here's a quick recap of what happened for those who missed it. On July 2019, a woman went to the emergency room after experiencing numbness in her hands and feet. The cause turned out to be methylmercury in her skin lightening cream. Now, no more than trace amounts of mercury are allowed in our cosmetic products, less than one part per million. To put that in perspective, the mercury in this product was more than 12,000 parts per million. That's a lot of mercury. The story reappeared again in the media on December 2019, right before the Christmas holiday, when the CDC reported her condition had worsened. The woman who initially went to the hospital for numbness was now unable to speak or care for herself. I got questions asking me about methylmercury, what the connection is between mercury and skin lightening, and does mercury really lighten skin? To understand what mercury has to do with skin lightening, let's first talk about the underlying chemical that gives our skin its color, melanin. The creation of melanin is driven by a complex series of chemical events, and one of the most important molecules in that process is an overachieving enzyme called tyrosinase. Tyrosinase drives melanin production through a multi-step pathway that eventually leads to the creation of a little baby melanin granule. Aw, cute! Huge amounts of these tiny melanin granules are packaged into organelles called melanosomes. These melanosomes are pumped out of the melanocyte by long tentacles called dendrites. From there, they get delivered to our skin cells. How exactly does tyrosinase do all this? Okay, go get your glasses on, because it's major geek out time. We're gonna get into the science and do a lightning fast overview of how the biochemical process actually works. A receptor on the surface of a melanocyte gets a message to switch on melanin production. Tyrosinase springs into action. Tyrosinase converts the non-essential amino acid tyrosine to dihydroxyphenylalanine, aka DOPA. Tyrosinase also oxidizes DOPA to dopaquinone. And from there, the three main types of melanin are made: black eumelanin, brown eumelanin, and the reddish-yellow pheomelanin. What did you do at work today? I bet you not as much as tyrosinase. You know how you get dark spots on bananas? That can be attributed to the presence of melanin. And here's what's cray. That process is actually being initiated by tyrosinase, just like our skin. The ratio between the black and brown eumelanin, yellow-red pheomelanin, along with the total amount of melanin in each melanosome and the number of melanosomes determines how dark or light our skin is. We often associate melanin with the darkening of tans, but melanin is produced as part of our normal, everyday pigmentation. Scientists call this our constitutive color. Okay, back to our story about the mercury-contaminated skin lightening cream and that poor woman I mentioned earlier. How does mercury make skin lighter anyway? It does so by putting the brakes on tyrosinase and preventing it from doing its job. It's sort of how like my little nephew interrupts me when his TAT is trying to work. Hi, Julian. Stop tyrosinase and stop melanin production. Stop tyrosinase and get a condition like this, called albinism, where melanin is not produced and skin turns white. At the heart of tyrosinase are two copper ions. The copper ions help the chemical reaction take place, which happens in the binding site or active site. It's the binding of copper that triggers tyrosinase to go to work. Then, tyrosine can enter the binding site and the magic reaction happens. But mercury is tricky and it can pull this great switcheroo. Mercury stops melanin creation by competing with copper for the binding site. The mercury ions interfere with the copper ions in tyrosinase, basically making tyrosinase a dud. And since tyrosinase can't make melanin anymore, skin gets lighter. Mercury is relatively inexpensive and has certain preservative properties that can extend a product's shelf life. It might have been put in the product to make the lightening effect look remarkable. And you know what? It works. Unfortunately, at the expense of your health. The long-term usage of this ingredient in products leads to chronic mercury poisoning, just like the woman I described in the video. Now, there are a lot of common skincare ingredients that are tyrosinase inhibitors. These include ingredients like hydroquinone, arbutin, kojic acid, and L-ascorbic acid. all have been used to lighten skin, and while some do have their drawbacks, they're not as toxic as mercury. Mercury exists in three forms: elemental, inorganic, and organic. What made this case unique is that the woman's skin lightening cream contained high amounts of the less common and more toxic organic mercury compound, methylmercury. Inorganic mercury compounds like mercury chloride or mercury iodide are water soluble. They can get into our blood and can do severe damage to the kidneys. They're slightly less damaging only because they don't stay in us as long. They ultimately leave our body the way all solid waste does. Organic mercury compounds like methylmercury are more problematic because they're attracted to fats. These compounds can bioaccumulate in myelin, the fatty layer that coats and protects nerve fibers that make up the brain and spinal cord of our central nervous system. Chemically, methylmercury causes damage inside the body through oxidative stress, where the loss of electrons from molecules damage cellular structures. So what can you do to protect yourself? Well, products with very high levels of mercury contamination can look gray, so avoid those. And don't buy a product if it's missing a foil seal. That's a red flag for contamination. Avoid buying products from countries where you're not familiar with the regulations, and always purchase from a reputable drugstore, pharmacy, or better yet, even a doctor. Getting the stuff from flea markets, street sellers, or over the internet where the source is difficult to track can put you at risk. When I originally shared this story, I got at least one comment from someone who said people should never lighten their skin and that all skin lightening products should be banned. What do you think? Share what you feel in the comments below, and I'll talk more about that and my own feelings in the next video. I also included a link to the original story in the description, just in case you want to give it a read for yourself.